We had our twin girls March 29th, and they're now 5 years old, and luckily very healthy and beautiful.
And their birthday was in the end of March, and they're going to graduate from preschool in June. They played soccer for the first time this year. To see them out there running around the soccer field, or to not be running around, to be standing picking daisies while the ball's going by. It's nice to just see sweet little girls happy.
5-10 years ago, we had nowhere near the positive results that we have today. We had nowhere near the understanding that we have today. And in essence, we've taken what has been, for most sets of twins, a lethal disease, we've made it manageable, and we have had tremendous success in creating survivors, and that's incredibly gratifying.
A profoundly remarkable characteristic is the dedication of the center towards the care of families affected by twin-twin transfusion syndrome.
A lot of our knowledge has just in this area has only come in the last few years. Of studying, injection studies of placentas.
We collaborate with our referring physicians as well as our families to have the placentas returned to us for formal pathologic examination. Part of that is so that we can gain a deeper appreciation for the mechanisms that are involved in twin-twin transfusion syndrome.
It becomes certainly a challenge for us to try to recognize what's going on and the best therapy to treat these, to give these families the best outcome possible.
We offer our patients that undergo selective laser the opportunity to return for a extensive neurodevelopmental as well as neonatal cardiac evaluation.
This is true translational medicine in that we are learning from our experience in managing these patients, and what we learn is very quickly converted into changes in how we make management decisions.
There's a huge debt that we owe to these families. They help us to advance the scientific purpose that we're here for. They help us to advance fetal treatment. And in addition, they're the life of the center.
Every single family's contribution increases the likelihood of future families having better outcomes.
They just bring such joy and such commitment to this experience, even if they're dealing with a situation that's less than optimal.
By allowing us to care for their pregnancy, care for their children, is probably the principal reason that we're able to make progress.
In many cases, the families and the patients teach us.
We learn so much from watching them.
Every family that we take care of adds to that education, adds to that learning.
The other valuable contribution is that we get feedback from them.
Absolutely, the best ideas come from families, and they've been through it and they've had a chance to reflect, and they give us feedback that helps us change and improve the program for the better.
They always provide me with a sense of hope.
I feel honored to be part of these, the lives of our families.
I think families get a sense for that, how special they are to us.
We are here to provide medical care, but really the families are here to teach us what we don't know, what we don't understand for future generations of children with these problems.